This week, I answer the question, what did the Centroid Acorn CNC retrofit of this Dynamite 2800 milling machine actually cost? Hey, it's Pete. Welcome back to the workshop. So over the last few weeks, I've received a number of requests to lay out the costs associated with the CNC retrofit. I decided that the best way to approach this was to separate the costs associated with acquiring the machine from the cost of the repairs and the cost of the retrofit hardware. Everyone's situation is going to be different, so I thought by separating out the various aspects of the project, it would make it easier for you to use as a basis for your own calculations. I'm also going to leave links down in the video description to all the items I used in this project. So first off, let's talk a bit about the machine itself. As best as I can tell, this machine was originally built in 1990. At that time, it would have had a purchase price of around $26,000, maybe slightly more because this machine had the 10K spindle option. Now, one important thing to keep in mind was this machine was already a CNC machine. It was equipped with ball screws and was built as a CNC machine from the factory. There was no need for me to do additional work or the costs associated with converting Acme screws to ball screws or fabricating brackets for stepper motors. All of that work was already done. I purchased it in 2013 at the Cabin Fever Expo auction, so I don't know anything about the backstory of the machine. Now, this was a case of me being at the right place at the right time, combined with an auction that had stretched way beyond the attention span of the bidders that were present. I ended up getting this machine for $50. On a side note, I also purchased an antique watchmaker's workbench that day for $10. It was one of my better days at the auction. The Dynamites are fairly well known for their build quality, so this was a pretty good starting point for this project. I proceeded to tear the machine apart and sold off the electronics that I wouldn't be using. This included the original stepper motor drivers, as well as the operator interface and some of the control boards. At this point, I had gotten my initial investment back and made an additional $100. I spent the next 6 years working on this machine on and off, and by 2019, I had pretty much everything cleaned up, but I hadn't started reassembling the machine yet. I needed to pick hardware for the control system. Now, my previous machine used Mach 3, and I investigated sticking with that or possibly going with Mach 4. It was around this time I decided that if I started a YouTube channel, it would help motivate me to finish the project. We have a large gantry mill at work that I had converted to the AHA control system back in the late 1990s. We later had this machine retrofitted to the Centroid MPU-11 system, so I had a passing familiarity with the Centroid software. For this reason, I decided to give the Centroid Acorn a try with this project. So I purchased the Acorn board and then picked some drivers for the stepper motors. I ended up going with the Gecko G251X drives. This package cost about $475. It should be noted here that I kept the 48-volt power supply from the original stepper drivers, and I also kept the stepper motors themselves, so I ended up saving some money there. If I decided to swap those out for closed-loop stepper motors or even servo motors, my retrofit cost would have been substantially higher. From here on, it was a buying frenzy of assorted DIN rail hardware and standoffs and contactors and switches and relays and fans and connectors and assorted other hardware that amounted to about $214. Around this time, Centroid announced their Ether 1616 expansion board for Acorn, so I picked up one of those while I was at it. I didn't have any immediate plans for the board. I have a vague idea of wanting to build an automatic tool changer in the future. Mostly, I just wanted to get it to make sure that I reserved enough space in the electrical cabinet for future expansion. This was another $299. One item that spent a whole lot of time on the back burner of this project was what to do about the spindle motor. The original machine used a brushless DC motor and drive. Unfortunately, I couldn't find any information about interfacing to this system, so I was on the lookout for a replacement. Eventually, I decided to try an AC servo motor. Initially, I picked a 750-watt motor from Dynamic Motor Motion, or DMM Tech. Later, I ended up upgrading this motor to a 1-kilowatt motor. With all the cables, this package came in at $678. As I got closer to getting the machine up and running, I decided to upgrade the CNC12 software to the Pro license. This gave me unlimited G-code file size, more work coordinate systems, and unlimited auto tool measuring. This upgrade was $159. The computer and related items, the cables, the keyboard, the mouse, the monitor, the mounting hardware came in at $935. There were a few additional purchases I made which I consider in the optional column. The Ether 1616 board came with its own power supply and Ethernet switch. I opted to replace those with DIN-rail mount versions. I also replaced the power supply for the Acorn with the DIN-rail mount version. And I purchased a braking resistor for the AC servo motor, which in the end, it turned out I didn't need. Those optional purchases added up to $141. And then finally, there were the expenses that were specific to my machine. These are the items that I purchased to either repair broken parts or replace missing items on my machine. They totaled to about $429. The amount you spend here is going to vary widely from machine to machine and has mostly to do with what your vision for the final product is compared to your starting point. There are a number of tools that I purchased or upgraded during this project. However, I'm not including them in the cost breakdown. I'm always happy to purchase new tools, and any excuse is pretty much a good enough excuse for me to purchase a new tool, so I didn't think it was fair to assign them to the cost of this project. I am, however, including links to some of my favorite tools down in the video description. So all in, we are just over $3,200 for this conversion, plus my time, and at this point, I have no idea what that is. Documenting the process here on YouTube dramatically increases the amount of time required to complete the project. There are areas where I could have saved money if I had used some parts that I had just laying around, and I didn't need to purchase the Ether 1616 board at all, or any of the optional components that I mentioned, but I just as easily could have spent even more money if I went the route of upgrading the stepper motor, so it's all just a question of trade-offs. I hope this gives you an idea what to consider when tackling your own CNC retrofit, some of the hidden costs you might run into. I know with finishing this project up over the last year, I had lost track of how much money I was spending, so getting this all down on paper was a good exercise for me. If you're new to this channel and you want to see this project from beginning to end, click that link to the left and I'll start you at day one. And if you're a fellow tinkerer and you want to follow along here in the workshop, click that subscribe button and see what project I get into next.